Hi and welcome to my fifth video in the series, and this one is looking at genetic crosses. So in this video we're going to be looking at a genetic cross looking at earlobe attachment, which is leading on from the previous video. And in this case we're looking at a mother with this genotype, and a genotype is the genetic makeup of an organism. So the mother has one dominant allele and one recessive, and the father has one dominant and one recessive. And both of them have this phenotype unattached. What this means is the dominant allele must be the unattached allele. So the big E represents the unattached, and the small e represents the attached earlobe. Now there's a specific name for this type of genotype where the two alleles are different, and that's referred to as heterozygous. Hetero meaning different. If the two alleles were the same, if they were small e, small e, then that would be referred to as homozygous. Also the same as if they were uppercase E, uppercase E. So heterozygous meaning different, homozygous meaning the same. Now the father's genotype is big E, small e. That means that in his sperm he only carries one of these alleles. That's very important. That gametes or sex cells, they only carry half the genetic information. So they only carry one allele for, in this case, earlobe attachment. And the father's sperm can either have the allele for unattached, or it can have the allele for attached. The same is true with the mother. And you'll notice these have been represented on this diagram. These are the sperm, obviously, with the tail, and these are the eggs. Now, on this part of the diagram, this section here, this is known as a Punnett square. And what it's showing is the different possibilities of the genotype of the offspring. So what you have are the two possibilities of the sperm. So the sperm can either have the unattached earlobe or it can have the attached. And here you have the eggs, which can have the unattached earlobe allele or the attached. And what we're going to do is we're going to put these together to form the genotype, or the possible genotype, of the offspring. So in this case it would be big E, big E, which would be a homozygous individual. In this case, big E from the mum, small e from the father, that makes this heterozygous. In this case, small e, big E, again this is another heterozygous genotype, because the small e from the egg, the big E from the sperm, and in this case, small e, small e, that's a homozygous individual because it has two recessive alleles. Now this shows the different possibilities that are available. Possibilities is a really key term here, because by chance you would expect the offspring between these two individuals, you would expect a 1 in 4 chance for them to have this genotype, a 1 in 2 chance to have these two genotypes, and a 1 in 4 chance to have these genotypes. So on the face of it you would say it's unlikely, or it's less likely, that these two individuals would have a child that has an attached earlobe. But obviously there's a 1 in 4 chance of that. The overwhelming outcome should be the fact that the child should have an unattached earlobe, because in 3 of the 4 cases, that's what the genotype indicates. But this doesn't mean to say that if these individuals had 3 kids, that they couldn't all have attached earlobes. I mean, it would be unlikely. The first kid having that genotype would be 1 in 4, the second would be 1 in 4, and the third would be 1 in 4. So there'd be a 1 in 64 chance. It is possible, but it's unlikely. Now, a carrier is what's technically known as an individual who carries the allele for a certain condition. So in this case, if the condition is having attached earlobes, then these two individuals that are heterozygous with the small e, big E, these two are what's technically known as a carrier. And if this was a genetic disease, we sometimes refer to this being a sufferer. So in a 25% case, you would expect this outcome. So in summary, a heterozygous individual, or heterozygous means a set of alleles which are different, so in this case big E, small e. Homozygous is a set of alleles which are the same, with this example big E, big E, or small e, small e. A carrier is an individual who carries the allele for the condition but doesn't have it, so they would be, in this case, heterozygous, big E, small e. And a sufferer, someone who has a particular condition, so in this case, small e, small e.